Oh. Holy moly. Oh my gosh. Praise Jesus. Oh. Full of joy. Praise the Lord. Praise Jesus.
Hey guys, we have baptism behind me right now. We're here at the Jesus Center. We have a PTS school start and a Luke 10 school started. 3 weeks and 3 months school. And we have 5 people getting baptized today. We have been talking about the gospel the last days, and 5 people are getting baptized. And it's so beautiful. Life is getting changed. So welcome to this little video.
The first one we are going to baptize is Simon. And I've been talking with him, and what was beautiful here is the time he wrote a paper of sins he have done. I like that somehow. It's not so often I get something so concrete. But it makes this more real, because this is going to be washed away now. Yeah. I actually thought about it when he went through his sins, because when you write it down, everything you have done, you see that you have sinned.
Yes.
But it's not because he's worse than any one of us, but we don't write it down. But if we took time to write down what we have done, try to imagine all those small things we have done, what we should have done we did not do, then it actually become a big list. And I would say there is freedom in confessing. And Satan is a liar. And people often think, oh, if I now confess my sin to that person, he will misuse it. Come on. We are all been guilty, we are all sinned. Mm. There is freedom in getting it out. Even if you have sinned and then fall again, then confess it. I had a person coming to me and want to confess things, but Satan wants to keep us away from freedom. Freedom is getting it out. And I want to say, if we are all learning, we are all growing. I don't care if you've been Christian 5 years, 10 years, 20 years. If there is something, get it out.
Jesus Christ.
Put out.
And I would say, now that's this part, remember, it's gone. It's buried. This is the whole life. And now when you step out of that water, you leave that behind. And it's forbidden to fish.
Oh, he's stepping out of
it. It's a new life, something new has started. It's beautiful. And I say that why are you here? We are here to learn. You don't learn this by just reading the Bible. You don't learn this on a university. You learn it by experience. You need to do it. Those small things, how to do it, how to talk with people. You don't just learn it. That is the discipleship. And I would say I'm really comfortable in what I'm doing now. I've done this many times, but remember, first time I baptized somebody, I was like, is it coming lighting down from heaven to kill me? Because nobody ordained me. Am I allowed to do it? And the first time it was like, okay, I baptize you in the name of Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Then later I baptize you in the name of Jesus, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. And then I came from Father, Son, Holy Spirit, Jesus. I was like really confused. I was afraid to change. It was difficult because my head, the fear was there. And then I did a little more. I saw, I got experience. And now it's like, love it. So this is why we are here. We are here to learn. We are here to see. So we can go, you can go home and do the same. I go by now, I go in the name of Jesus, come on. Come on.
It was like something coming out of my chest. It was in my chest, and I was like stuck there for a minute, and then it just. This is so beautiful.
It's a new life.
I feel so much lighter and full of joy. Praise the Lord. Praise Jesus. Thanks, you guys. Thank you so much.
Repent, get baptized, and you shall receive the Holy Spirit. Go to tlrmap.com. Find people near you who are green on the map. They can connect with you, they can meet with you, they can share the gospel, and take the time to lead you through repentance, baptism, water, and Holy Spirit.